qui se retrouve une deuxième fois.
C'est la deuxième ronde, ça a commencé en première période, cette histoire entre Clark et Wendell Clark, et entre Morrow, c'est-à-dire Wendell Clark, et là, on essaie de se libérer. La droite de part et d'autre, deux enfants, ça se bouscule toujours.
Il reste 7 minutes 2 secondes à faire en deuxième, en direct du Mépoulis.
When you're intimidated or somebody comes at you.
Well, I like to play it and play on my terms. Like nobody gets a piece of you without getting a piece of them. Or just gotta go out there and play hard. And you're in a one-on-one basis, and you try to win the one-on-one basis all the time.
We talked about this last spring. I think that last year you earned a reputation such that you might be left alone more this year. What do you think about that possibility?
And watch when.
Took that one. Yes, he did. Big John, who's one of the better separators among linesmen in the league, he took a punch right in the forehead. And he looks like he's fairly badly cut. They're rushing the towel out to
talk about.
Clark and Graham. Clark and Graham are slugging it out. Wendell Clark and Dirk Graham standing toe to toe, and each man had to land a half a dozen.
Well, Clark ran over Graham. He took the opportunity as Graham was off balance, reaching to clear the puck. Clark got the elbow up and flattened him. Ben Wilson tried to get at Clark. Secord got Ben.
Fakes the drive, then moves it ahead. They'll put it up into the crowd, and play stops.
Lazaro went to the linesman, didn't get out of the way of the puck, and it was kept in the zone. Clark and Hardy. Oh, man. Wendell Clark. You know, Rob Schick missed the play where Wendell Clark ran Mark Hardy in the board, elbows up. No penalty was called there. And then Mark Hardy had to take on Wendell Clark. Well,
Rangers figured tonight would be fairly quiet with Bordick out. And Rudy Poshek did not dress, but Wendell Clark is very physical.
See the elbows that stick up in Mark Hardy's face? That should have been called right away, then nothing else would have happened. Now Hardy gets up, and Wendell Clark's in his face, and they go, and Wendell Clark, when he gets...
Third period, 16:46 left in it, there go... Oh, a shot taken by Clark on Fetisov, who's not retaliating.
Well, that's absolutely, positively has to be 5 minutes for Clark, no minutes for Fetisov.
Fetisov looked like, you can't be doing this, kind of disbelief when Clark started swinging at him.
Well, that's
it. Done. Let's take a look at it again.
Gary, I don't like to not say things about the referee, This is just a brutal call. Watch Clark go after him. That's not a fight. He didn't drop his gloves and fight Fetisov. That is a five-minute major. That's a brutal call by Gregson right there.
Surprising Ben Wilson. You were the guy, you actually started this. I was watching you. I was one of those guys in Hockey Night in Canada. Tell us about this here beautiful little scrap here.
I don't know. We went to the side of the boards, and sticks got up, and I guess we didn't get along too well.
You're catching a good one there. You come back there. He's a pretty tough guy. Ben is probably one of them. He got his sweater over his head. That's one of the best things, eh?
Well, the thing I figured, if I stopped swinging, I was dead, so I just kept swinging.
Look at he's one of the toughest guys in the league. He's all right, too. You got him with an uppercut here pretty soon. Now, that's not bad. Nice little scrap. All right, okay. Thank you.
Started in behind the play. Probert and Clark. Probert got the first two or three licks in. And is still going.
Probert can really fight, Bob, and he's got a big reach advantage on Wendel Clark.
They'll go for major penalties. Big Probert giving Clark a few shots from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. This is Hockey Night in Canada. Gallant rolled it back in front. It comes near the line. And a scrap is started and Semenko is in there with Probert. Probert, remember, gave it to Wendel Clark and he's taking some now, but now he gets loose. This is going to be a massive scrap because everybody is pairing off now. Semenko is still throwing hard right hands at Probert, even though the two linesmen are trying to keep them apart.
And isn't it strange that it's not Stickle who can't hold his man, it's Civic who can't hold his man. But Semenko will definitely get the aggressor, the instigator.
And Semenko is still getting a right hand loose.
And Gerard Gallant may well have been the third man in. There was a third man, as he thought Probert was getting pounded badly, as Probert didn't throw a punch in the first half of this. And Gerard Gallant, 17, I think is telling Gill there, I didn't want to come in. But Semenko jumped Probert.
That looks like the Dave Semenko of old, because we know about his reputation. Despite the Leafs coasting home to victory here in game one. Anderson comes in. Gilmore was hit inside the line by McSorley. And this is going to draw Clark and McSorley into a racket. They're going, throwing punches. Oh, Clark is nailing McSorley. Now McSorley comes back. Gilmore was hit inside the line. He's still down. He hasn't moved. Gilmore trying to get up. McSorley was grabbed by Clark, who threw that hit on Gilmore. And Clark and McSorley are flailing away each other, two of the heavyweights of the league, and no nonsense here, they're going at it. McSorley has the sweater off, and Clark nails him with another uppercut. Now Clark gets hit, ducks away from one. McSorley now pounding away, and the two linesmen just scared to take a chance on getting in there, I guess. Finally they get in, but Clark came back to McSorley, and they went at it.
He wants to take everybody on.
Boy, this is nasty feelings now with 2:34 left in the third period. There's another scrap on in case you're interested. It's Todd Gill and Taylor. They're going at it just inside the L.A. line. And the officials are having a tough time getting this one under control. McSorley goes to the dressing room.
Well, McSorley threw the initial hit on Doug Gilmore as Gilmore came across the blue line. Right across the blue line with his head down. And when Clark saw the hit by McSorley, he ran after him right away and started the battle. Gilmore appears to be all right. He gets up and goes over and wants to take on the LA bench. I think, although I want to see the replay, there was nothing wrong with the hit by McSorley. But it was on the wrong guy. Let's have a look. You can't cut across the offensive zone with your head down. But Gilmore tries it, and now he's in trouble. And it might have been an elbow. It might have been an elbow. No doubt about that. But you can't